Hello and hi all. Let us discuss the synthesis of atropine. Atropine, the molecular structure is like this, and its molecular formula is T17H23NO3, molecular mass 289. It's an alkaloid. It's a drug against a slow heart rate. It's an antidote for certain drug and poisoning. And it's also used to reduce salivation during surgery. Let us have a closer look at this structure. So it contains a nitrogen and this bicyclic ring. And this is racemic. So actually, if the molecule is like this, this particular enantiomer, the molecule is called a hyoscyamine. And if it's a racemic mixture, that means both enantiomers are present in equal amount, then this is called atropine. So that's a curious factor here. So this has to be racemic. So the mixture of this. So let's try to do the retrosynthesis of this molecule. Retrosynthesis is basically breaking bonds and make this big molecule into smaller molecules so that we can get an idea how to synthesize this molecule from a simple starting material. All these exercises are done on paper. So theoretically breaking bonds, etc. So let's do that. In this molecule, breaking a bond here is, seems to be logical because an alcohol here and an acid here can make an ester bond here. So let's do that. So let us go for the theoretical bond breaking. So obviously this will be, an autocorrection and it's an OH. And here, this is an acid actually. We can make this molecule from an acid and corresponding alcohol. Actually, the molecule is made from these two molecules. This is tropin and this is tropic acid. We can combine these together and do an esterification and make atropine. Now, how can we make this molecule? Let's do the retrosynthesis of that one. So obviously we can make it from tropinone. Now the question, how can we make this tropinone? So there are synthetic ways to make this molecule with 15 steps or so, but there's a great synthesis which does the same thing in one step. So let's do the retrosynthesis of that way. So here you can see this is a ketone, a breaking F bond like here, here, and then here, here. Okay, so for bone breaking, so let's copy it down and break the bones. Obviously, breaking here, let's break here, and let's break here, and let's break here, and let's break here. So we can break it like this because this is simply butane, which won't work. So we have to make it logical. So an aldehyde here, we can think of an aldehyde here, which can react with this amine and can do a Mannich reaction. Okay, so succinylaldehyde, methylamine, and acetone can do the reaction. In one step, they can make tropinone, which on reduction will give you tropinone, which on reaction with or esterification with the tropic acid will give you atropine. So let's go for the retrosynthesis of this tropic acid. So instead of this, let's break it here. So that is an addition here. That's to addition to an aldehyde. Addition to an aldehyde will give you an alcohol. So we have formaldehyde and this 2-phenyl acetic acid, which are the precursors of tropic acid. Okay, so we have completed the retrosynthesis. So then we combine both of them to form atropine. So that means it's a convergent synthesis. We can say it is a convergent synthesis. And this reaction here, this is a Mannich reaction, actually a double Mannich reaction. Even in the biosynthesis of atropine, this Mannich reaction happens. So this approach is actually a biomimetic approach. So this is tropine. This tropine can be prepared from tropinone, and the synthesis of tropinone is by R. Robinson. So this synthesis is very important in the history of organic synthesis, because this gives, you know, this is one of the synthesis which gave the idea, or which used the idea of biomimetic synthesis. So mimicking the actual process in biology or biosystem, so we can make molecules in laboratory. Synthesis of tropinone by R. Robinson is a pioneering work. He published this work in 1917 in Journal of Chemical Society Transaction. There are several methods of synthesis of tropine. The earlier one included like around 15 steps, but this synthesis involves just two steps. One step to make tropinone, and then the reduction of it to make tropine. Now the synthesis of tropic acid. Tropic acid synthesis is by Blicke, F F, and et al. It was published in Journal of American Chemical Society in 1952. So let us see the mechanism by which the tropinone is formed. So the first we have to show the lone pair on nitrogen. This nitrogen will react with the aldehyde molecule here. So let's show the curved arrow. Now a new bond is forming, an old bond has to break here. The pi bond will break. Let's show that with another curved arrow. Now let us show the bond. So the bond, new bond will be like this, that is this bond, and old bond will have to break there. So an old bond is breaking. This is auto correction actually. This is actually a negative charge. Okay, let me show a positive charge on nitrogen. So also this is a negative charge. Now what? Now this O minus or negative charge will pick up a proton from here. Let's show with the curved arrow. And this is the curved arrow, and this old bond will break. That means the nitrogen-hydrogen bond will break. So indicated with a curved arrow. Now let's make the bond and break the bond. So this is the new bond, and the old bond will break. So there is no longer a charge on nitrogen. So that was autocorrection. Now we have, you know, only one hydrogen on this nitrogen. Now what? Now the lone pair on nitrogen is back, and it can react again with another molecule of another aldehyde moiety. And I'll show that with the curved arrow. An old bond has to break, so this pi bond is breaking. Now we showed the curved arrows. Now let us show the real bond there. So this is the real bond. An old bond will break at that time. So again, this should be an O minus. That's auto correction. It's coming as OH, and there are no positive charge on nitrogen now. Actually, there should be a positive charge because there are four bonds to it. So let's do those things. So negative charge on oxygen and positive charge on nitrogen. Now again, this O minus will pick up this proton. So curved arrow. Now let's write the bonds. Okay. So we have our structure. We have a structure like this. So let's do a little bit beautification like that. And now there's again this lone pair. Now we are set. Now the stage is set for the double Mannich reaction. So this lone pair can do an elimination like this, and this OH minus can be eliminated. So let's show the curved arrow. So OH minus can be eliminated. Now the new bond is formed. An old bond has to break. So that bond. Now the nitrogen will have a positive charge now. So let's make a little bit of beautification there. And now again, this ketone can be in equilibrium with its enol form. So let's show the enol form. So this is the enol form. This enol can attack this carbon. So let's show the curved arrow. So attack can happen like this. The first, this all the lone pair on electron comes here. At the same time, this attacks this carbon. So let's show the curved arrow. Okay, the attack happens like this. Hope you understood this. And now we can write the bonds. Oh no, before that. So this bond also, this pi bond also breaks. And let's draw the bonds. So there is a positive charge on this oxygen, and there is going to be a new bond, and old bond will break now. I mean, at the same time, and there are no positive charge on nitrogen. So that was autocorrection. So we removed the hydrogen and the positive charge. So we have a new bond here. Now the lone pair on nitrogen is back again. So this can again remove this OH minus, remove this OH as OH minus. So let's show the curved arrows. Now let's make the bonds. So the bond is there. Okay. The old bond has to break. Now this moiety can be an enol again by losing a proton. So it's an enol, and there are no charges on this oxygen now. And this will again do the same thing. This a lone pair of electron will come back. I mean, we can show that. Let's show it. Okay. Now again, this can attack this part. An old bond will break. Now let's show the bonds. It's a new bond. This new carbon bond is here. Let's move the curved arrow. And so this is again neutral nitrogen. That hydrogen was autocorrection, so that was not really there. So you know, this deprotonation can lead to this tropinone. So this is actually tropinone, a bit of beautification. You know, it will look like our structure. Okay, so this is tropinone. So this is the mechanism for double Mannich reaction to get this tropinone. Now the reduction of tropinone will give you tropine. So the tropinone is like this, and reduction, you can use sodium amalgam and HCl, or a metal and an acid like zinc with HI can give you the reduction, and the reduction will lead to this alcohol tropine. Tropine can be written like this or this. All are, you know, same molecule, tropine. So there are different ways of writing it. I mean, this might be the one giving more justice to the actual structure. Now that we made tropine, we have to make tropic acid. For that, this phenyl acetic acid is treated with the isopropyl glycinate. This is practically a carbanion, which will pick up this hydrogen, and a magnesium will be here. And also then, this will pick up a proton from here. At this stage, glycinate is acting as a base. It picked up a proton from here, and it's also picked up a proton from this carbon. So we have to use isopropyl grignard in excess, at least two equivalents. Now this is a grignard reagent, as the carbon magnesium Cl, this is a RMgCl. It's a grignard reagent that can react with an aldehyde. So we used an appropriate aldehyde here, that is formaldehyde. On reaction with the formaldehyde, you will get a species like this. And this, on protonation, will lead to our tropic acid. So we make tropine and tropic acid. Now we can combine them together. There are different ways of combining them. So we can protect this OH as acetyl group. Then we can activate this carboxylic acid as acid chloride using thionyl chloride. Then we can do the esterification, though combine these two, and ester will form. And then the protection can be removed. Deprotection can be done with KOH. So that's one way. But esterification can be done directly also using HCl, this OH, and COH can be combined to form the ester, making this molecule atropine. So let us go over this reaction once again. So to make atropine, we will make tropin and tropic acid, then combine them together. To make tropin, we can do a one-pore reaction to make tropinone. So we use succinaldehyde, methylamine and acetone, or the carboxylic acid version of acetone and its salt. Actually, the calcium salt of carboxylic acid version of acetone. So acetone carboxylic acid salt can be used to make tropinone. Then reduction using metal and acid will give you tropin. Now for the tropic acid, so 2-phenyl acetic acid with isopropyl grignard will give you another grignard reagent, this one. This one reaction with the formaldehyde will give you this species, which on protonation will lead to tropic acid. Once tropin and tropic acid combines to form the ester bond here, and the molecule is atropine. Hope you understood the synthesis of atropine. Thank you and have a good day.